the angel of the Lord, brought tidings to Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to thy will. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion may we come to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. In tuo ego altare Dei, vengo in edificare io con tutto me. Io ricamerei sergione casamente a gente non sancta, ma nomine nemmeno quando lo assorro me. Quae tu stai us fulti tu me, corre pulissis, quale tristis in cielo, come frigi me, nemicus. Emite luce in tu me veritatem, tu missimi dei tuc serum, tu tuc serum, ti montum sanctum tuum, et ita panacula tua. Et in tuo ego altare Dei, vengo in edificare io con tutto me. Confidebo ti vincitura, Deus, Deus meus, quae tristis anima mea, corre con tuo vers me. Sperin Deo quoni mai tocum te vini, salutare vultus me et Deus meus. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et sempre, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In tuae volatari Dei, vengo nitifica Deo per tutto me. Auditori nostri in nomine Domini, qui feci cedum et terra. Confidio Domini potenti, via di mani e sepidi, via di mani e carni, 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 miseria tutti gli onnipotenti Deus e i miei peccati tu espluca te vita eterna. Amen. Confidio Deo onnipotente, beata Maria sempre vigili, beata Michele Arcangelo, beata Ioanne Battista, sancti apostoli spiriti e padre, omnibus sancti se ti riparte, quia peccavi nimis cogitazione, verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed eo prego beata Maria sempre vigili, beata Michele Arcangelo, beata Ioanne Battista, sancti apostoli spiriti e padre, omnes sanctos et te pater, ora ricome Dominum del nostro. Miseria tutti gli unicutens Deus in missis peccatis, lui spiluta te vita metano. Amen. In urgentiam sursionem tremissione peccatorum nostro, in tribunat nomis in divotente misericordiamus. Amen. Deus tu conversa specificatis nostri, reptemus vile servitor in te, o sede nobis Domine misericordia tua, et salutare tuum da nobis. Domine exali ratione mea, et clamo me se te venia. Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo, oremus. Eci advenit dominator Dominus, et regum in manu eius, et potestas, et imperium. Deus judicium tuum regidae, justitiam tuum filio regis. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Ecce advenit dominator Dominus, et regnum in manu eius, et potestas, et imperium. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax omnibus bone voluntatis, adamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te. Gratis agimus tibi prote magum gloriam tuam, Domine Deus rex celestis, Deus pater omnipotens, Domine filii unigenite Iesu Christe, Domine Deus omnius Dei filius patris, qui tollis peccatum mundi miserere nobis, Vitalis peccato mundi suscipe deprecazione nostra, qui sedis et extream partis miserere nobis, quoniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus altissimus, Jesu Christe, cum sanctus spiritu in gloria Dei patris. Amen. Ex vobis et cum spirito tuo. Oremus. Deus, qui hodierne di unigenitum tuum gentibus terra duce revelasti, concede propitius, ut qui ante ex fide coniovimus usque contemplandam speciem tuae celestitudines perducamur. Veriundum Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium tuum, qui tecum vivit regni ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Oremus. Deus qui salutis aeterne beate Mariae virginitatis fecunda, cum anno generi venia praesisti, crepio equestus, ut vixam pro nobis in decedere essentiamus, ergo meruimus autorum vitis suscipere Dominum nostrum Iesu Christum Filium tuum. Ecclesiae tue questus Domine preces locatus ermite, ut istruxis epices asibus et voribus universis et porit qui sepia debitate, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium tuum, qui tecum vivit regni ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lex Isaiae prophete, suge illuminare Jerusalem, qui avenit lumen tuum, et gloria Domini subite orta est, quae ecce tenebrae operunt terram et gallico populus, subite autem orrietur Dominus, et gloria eius in te videbitur. Et ambulabant gentes in lumine tuo, et regis in splendore otus tui. Lever incipuitu oculus tuus, et vide, omnis isti collegati sunt venerunt, filii tui de longe veniunt, et filie tui de la terre surgerent. Dum videbis et affluens veribatur et dilitabitur quotum, quando conversa fruerit ad potituto maris, potituto gentium venerit tibi. Inundatio cavallarum operie te, glomedarie madia le defa, omnes de sabe venien aurum et puste fedentes, et laudem Domino annunciantes. Deo gratias. Omnes de sabe venien aurum et puste fedentes, et laudem Domino annunciantes, suge illuminare Jerusalem, quia gloria Domini subete orte eis. Alleluia, alleluia, vidimus tem eus in oriente et venimus cum menuneribus et orari Dominum. Alleluia. Dominus obiscum et cum spirito tuo sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Matthaeum. Gloria tibi, Domine. Cum natus esit Iesus in Bethlehem Iuda redientibus Herodis regis, ecce magi ab oriente venerunt Hierosolymam, dicentes, ubi est qui natus ex rex Iudaeorum? Vidimus enim stellam eius in oriente, et venimus adorare eum. Audiens autem Herodes rex tubatus est, et omnis Hierosolyma comino. Et congregans omnes principes sacerdotum et scribas populi, sicitabatur ab eis, ubi Christus ascendetur. Et illi dixerunt ei, in Bethlehem Iudae, sic enim scriptum est pro propheta. Et tu, Bethlehem, terra Iuda, nequaquam minima res in principibus Iuda, ex te enim exi et lux, quir reget populum meum Israel. Sunt Herodes advocatis magis, diligenta dicit ab eis tempus tene, quae abernuit eis. Et mitens illos in Bethlehem, dixit, ite, et interrogati diligentor de nuero, et cum veneritis renunciate mihi, ut et ego veniant ad orre meum. Quo cum audisse in regem avieni, et ecce stella, quam viderant in oriente, ante gigebat eus, usque dum venenien salet supra, ubi erat puer. Videntes autum stellam gadisi sub gaudio magno valde, et intrantes domum invenerunt puerum cum Maria Mater eius, et procedentes adoraverunt eum, et apertis daus auris suis, obtulerunt de munera aurum pus et miram. Et responso accetto in somnis, ne ridebint ad Herodem, per aliam viam revesi sunt in regionem sua. Love, Stevie Christ. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedictus mulieribus, benedictus sunt gentis tu, Iesus, Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast mass on this, the second day in the octave of the Epiphany. As we reflected yesterday, Epiphany, of course, meaning manifestation, and in the Greek, theophany, meaning revelation. And as we discussed yesterday, during this week, we will reflect on the three manifestations that this octave commemorates. Of course, in the first instance, the manifestation of the Christ child to the Gentiles, represented by the Magi. Then, of course, the manifestation of the triune Godhead at our Lord's baptism in the River Jordan, and then the manifestation of Christ's divinity in the performance of his first miracle at the wedding of Cana in Galilee. Today, however, let us focus on the first manifestation, the Epiphany, the arrival of the Magi, otherwise known, of course, as the wise men. But who were these strangers from foreign lands? They were, of course, strangers. We see them depicted here in the crib. Indeed, we have one of each, as it were, different color of humanity. We have very black, a dark-skinned colored person, possibly from Africa. We have a tanned-colored wise man, possibly representing Persia or Arabia or the Arabians and the Middle East. And then we have a Caucasian, white-looking figure, possibly referring to the Mediterranean. In any case, the phenomena of magi or magus comes to us from, oh, well, at least the 5th century, where Darius in Persia writes and tells us about the magi. And the magi may have been a mixture of things, and indeed the etymology of the word is quite confusing itself. Certainly it derives from the Middle East and certainly from the Eastern Mediterranean, but it is found not just in Persian and Arabic, but also in Greek and even in Chinese. There is a suggestion that the Magi were Zoroastrian priests, that they were followers of a particular pagan religion, or that they indeed were simply wise men in government positions. Certainly, we know that in the 5th century they seemed in the kingdom of Persia to hold particular offices in government, of advice, and indeed even of education, even being responsible for the education of the emperor. The word that in Greek is where, of course, we derive our word magic and magician in a roundabout kind of way, but from that Greek root. And it is the only place in the second chapter of St. Matthew's Gospel where that word is used and translated, sorry, as wise men. And in other places, it is used to refer to magicians. And of course, the whole concept of these magi in history is that perhaps they were practiced in particular arts, perhaps they were magicians, perhaps they were people imbued with the knowledge of the stars, they were astrologists or astronomers, in all sorts of weird and strange ways. The etymology of the word and the nature of the person applied to it have being confused and are different in all sorts of different cultures. However, there is a long-standing tradition in Christianity that the Magi were perhaps descended from those of the Jews who were left behind in Babylon after the exile to Babylonia, after the return of the Jews to Israel. There were some who were left behind, and perhaps they became magi, they became court physicians and advisors and government officials and educators and educators of royalty. They were certainly, it would seem, have accomplished a great deal or accumulated a great deal of knowledge and were looked to certainly as wise people. And the suggestion is therefore that these magi, or at least some of these magi, may have developed a tradition from the time of Babylonian captivity, and they had a knowledge of the Hebrew scriptures, and with their, together with their knowledge of astronomy, and together with their supposed knowledge of astrology, etc., etc., that the long and short of it is that they may well perhaps have been familiar with the prophecies concerning the Christ child, and that they indeed were forever watching the stars and noticed the strange appearance of this star and recognized and knew what it meant, what it foretold, what it portended. So it was that whether or not they all came from one place, or whether, as often they are depicted, they may have come from different nations, they fulfill in themselves that prophecy of the Messiah being revealed to the Gentiles. And indeed that is the role they fulfill in the Epiphany. They come representing the Gentiles coming to pay homage to the Messiah of the world. Now we, my brothers and sisters, in our own time, are not unfamiliar with the concept of people supposedly imbued with knowledge concerning the stars, concerning astrology, as well as astronomy, concerning all sorts of weird and wonderful things, and certainly magic still has a place in the minds of contemporary people. Still, there is great work for illusionists and magicians of every kind, and of course we still have a fascination with things that we cannot immediately or always explain. Now, some, of course, in our contemporary age are becoming more scientific in their appreciation of the world, and no doubt that in the vast majority of cases for illusionists and magicians, there is a simple science and a simple logic going on. There is all that sleight of hand as well, all the artistry of it, etc. And certainly, my brothers and sisters, there are people who are looking for answers, looking for explanations to their sense of spirituality, to their sense of spiritual things. And so it is that we have people who consult tarot cards and Ouija boards and soothsayers and truthsayers and oracles and fortune tellers, etc. We, my brothers and sisters, then, as Christians, as baptized Christians, ought ourselves in our aiding, and remember that our part of our duty, part of the discipleship of a Christian, is to make manifest Christ in the world. Thus, my brothers and sisters, we as Christians should be manifesting the revelation of the truth that is contained in Christ and his gospel, which is the truth about God, which is the truth about the world and about the universe. And we, my brothers and sisters, should be trying to help those who clearly have an interest in the spiritual, who clearly are searching for answers, who clearly are seeking the truth. We have a responsibility, just as the prophets did of old, just as the apostles did, to present to them the Messiah, the Christ, the God made manifest, Emmanuel, God with us. We are to present to them God who saves, Jesus. We are to present to them the manifestation of God in Christ, that they may see the truth for themselves. Because as is so often the case, and we ought, my brothers and sisters, to remember to pray for those who are imprisoned by vice, but also, of course, may be said to be imprisoned by magic or their understanding or lack of understanding of spiritual things. We, my brothers and sisters, ought to try to dissuade people from going to fortune tellers, from trying to organize their lives according to the stars printed in the paper. We should try and strive to bring them into reality, into a spiritual reality. Indeed, my brothers and sisters, so much of the 20th century
seems lost to virtual reality, all these getting lost in computer games, or whether he's getting lost through hallucinogenic drugs, or whether he's getting lost in strange forms of spirituality and magic and mysticism, etc. And these people, my brothers and sisters, if we don't do something about it, they become isolated, they become ensnared and entrapped, nay, even imprisoned by these distractions which take them away from the reality of the universe as it is, from the reality of humanity as it is, from the recognizing the necessity of the reality of salvation. Indeed, my brothers and sisters, for all these distractions take us away from focusing on the reality necessary for us to attain heaven, for us to live with God, for us to recognize Him in Christ, and for us, therefore, to change and transform our lives and have a better understanding of the world around us. Ours, my brothers and sisters, is not just a faith based in emotion, but it is a faith based in rationality, in reasoning. If we look at the last 2,000 years of the Church's history, and we count up the number of scholars and great minds who, through the centuries, have not only developed our understanding of theology, but may even have indeed developed our understanding of the world around us through the sciences. Remember, almost all of the great scientists, or those who have discovered the great steps towards the development of science, even in our own century, have been themselves Christians, were themselves faith believers. But we would not call them distracted by virtual reality. We would not regard them as irrational persons. And indeed, they weren't. They were great minds. They were great scholars. And yet they too recognized the truth of God revealed in Christ. They too recognized the objective truths contained in the gospel. They too saw reality for what it is and understood that without faith, as well as reason, we cannot hope to understand or to have a full grasp of what this world is about and what the purpose of our existence is, which of course all comes down to understanding the reality of the incarnation, to understanding the reality, the truth of God being made man, that we might become like Him. Let us then, my brothers and sisters, so determine that we will try to make manifest ourselves, Christ, to the world, particularly to those who are distracted by virtual reality, particularly by those who are seeking the truth but struggle and are falling by the wayside through distractions and through paths that go away from the truth. Let us, my brothers and sisters, use the great wealth and body of Christian apologetics that has been developed over the last 2,000 years, that has developed our contemporary understanding of so many things in philosophy, aside from theology, and in the sciences. But let us also recognize that ultimately and fundamentally, however much we might better appreciate the world around us, however better we might appreciate our life on earth, all of it is as nothing if we do not seek to attain to be with Him for all eternity, who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum Deum, Patrem omnipotentem, factorum caeli et terrae, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum, Filium Dei unigenitum, et ex patrem nostrum ante omnia saecula. Deum de Deo lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero, genitum non factum consubstantialem Patri, pecum omnia factus sum. Qui propter nos homines et propter nostrum salutem descendit de caelis, et incarnatus est Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine et homo factus est. Crucifixus est semper nobis sub Pontio Pilato, passus et sepultus est, resere exitus, id in sepulcro scripturas, et ascendere in cenus et ad extram patris, et iterum venturis est cum gloria judicari vivos et mortuos, cuius veni non erit finis. Et in spiritum sanctum dominum et vivificantem qui ex patria procedi, qui cum patria et filius semanatorator cum glorificatur quod occultus est per profetas. Et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confiti unum baptismum et missione peccatorum, et expecto resurrectione mortuorum, et vita veturi seculi. Amen. Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Oremus. Reges tasis et insule munere offerunt, reges arabam et sabae dona educent, et adonabunt eum omnes reges terrae, omnes gentes serviunt ei.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, susum corda, habemus ad Dominum, gratias agamus Domino Deo nostro, dignum et justum est, verre dignum et justum et tecum salutare nos dimisembre dubito et gratias agere Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens Eterni Deus, quia cum unigenitus suus in substantia nostri mortali partis separli, nobe nos immortalitatis sui luce reparavi. Et in Deo come angelis ad angelis cum trones et nominationibus cumque omni milice celestis exercitus, et un gloria et tue canimus sine fine dicente. Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus Sabaoth, pleni sunt caeli et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis. Thank you. Nobis quoque peccatoribus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Ordinus, proregepti salutaribus morti divinis functione formatio de mysticio. Pater noster qui es in caeli, sanctificet nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in caelo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris. Et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Sed libera nos a mal. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Thank you. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato mundi.
Domine non sunt ignus, ut in Jesu tecum meum, sed tantum in verbo et sanabitur anima mea.
Domine non sunt ignus, ut in Jesu tecum meum, sed tantum in verbo et sanabitur anima mea.
Domine non sunt ignus, ut in Jesu tecum meum, sed tantum in verbo et sanabitur anima mea.
Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion, the words for which you will find below your viewing screen. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Thank you.
Vidimus terra meus in oriente, et venimus comuneribus adorare Domine.
Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo, ordemus.
Presta quesmus omnipotens Deus, utque solemni celebramus officio, purificate mentis intelligentiae consecravur, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum divitat regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Ordemus. Et nos communio Domine purget a crimine, et intercedente Beata Virgine de Genetrice Maria, celestis remedii faciat esse consortes. Quaesumus Domine Deus noster, ut quos divina tribuis participatione cadere, humanis non sinus abcere periculis, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo, ite missa est, Deo gratias.
Se nomen Domini benedictum, ex omnum dusque in saecula, obitorum nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terra. Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus.
Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo, initium sancti evangelii secundum Ioannem, gloria tibi Domine. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat ad Deum, et Deus erat verbum, hoc erat in principio ad Deum, omni principum factus sunt, et sin factus nihilo factum est. In ipso vide erat lux omnium, et lux aeternus, lux et aeternus verbum comprehende erat. Quid homo missus Deum in nomine erat Ioannes, in veritate testimonium ut testimoni per verbum, et lumen et omnes credunt quibus. Non erit in lux, erat testimoni per verbum, et erat lux vere, quae luminat omnem, omnium credientem in locutum. In modo erat, modus ipsum factus est, modus in locum meum, vid in propria veritis omnes non ceperum. Quorum tem ceperum tem dedes forestati filios Dei fieri, ut qui prendi nomine eius, qui non ex sanguinibus nec contentati carnis, nec quae voluntati viris erit Deo nati sunt. Et verbum carnis factum est. Et habitavit in nobis et vidimus gloria meus gloria quasi unigenitia Patris plenum gratiae veritatis. Deo gratias.